Yep. So found this out in the garage. RGM. R-R-E-M. Man, I actually took time on these things. R-E-M, right there. The coolest tunes. Yeah, from the Georgia Boys. Coolest tunes from the Georgia Boys. I sure hope they're from Georgia. Otherwise, it'd be silly. Anyway, this is a tape that I made way back in collage. I would guess this is probably from 1989, is this particular collection, because you will find on here that it kind of dead ends on the Green album. You got Orange Crush and Stand and tunes of that flavor. Light Switch Pageant. There is nothing from Out of Time on here, which is a perennial favorite of people. That's me in the corner. That's me in the spotlight. I'm losing my religion. I can sing it better than that. I'm just dicking around. So, this is the tape. And I put it in here. See? This is it. R.E.M. And I'm going to slide it right in there and I close it. Let's see what it sounds like these decades later. Really, this... Holy moly, this is 3 decades old. Let's see what it sounds like. Vitology. Pearl Jam album, but it was actually this book initially, huh? While we're waiting for it to do something. Anything? Maybe something? Oh, I hear something. Ooh. A little bit of Radio Free Europe for your flavors. Spinning. Well, this is kind of funny. 30 years ago, it's totally muted. It's lost the high end. Huh. Funny to me, though. There you go. Hey, let me tell you a tale about Green Day. Or not Green Day. Sheesh. Green's name of the album, but Green, the album. We went down to Las Cruces, Nueva Mexico, to go see. And my buddy Pam, who, the reason why I'm telling the story is because of Pam, was all the way away with Kurt and some other people. And I was with a different group of individuals from Mexico Tech. And she just said that in this big old arena, I think it's called the Pan American, this big old arena, that it was pretty easy, Pam said, to actually spot me because I was the guy dancing like a freaking maniac. And it just says that is, well, she said that was always something cool about me. And the story she shared with me maybe about a month before she passed away at a very far too young age, and February of 2011. So anyway, that one's for you, Pam. I do miss you a lot. You are always a very good friend.